Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Gil from Black Hole Comics, and today we're going to be reviewing the comic variant Spider-Man from Mafex. This thing is beautiful. As you can see, I'm going to get into a comparison right off the bat. This thing is beautiful, done in very nice, like, cel-shaded comic book. Oh, God, like, you can see, like, the sketch lines. It's amazing. Just incredible detail. Just, I know that I said I was going to do a comparison, but Jesus, this thing is amazing. Look at the spider booty. Amazing glutes right there. Look at that. Just all up in your face. And the spider crotch. Symbol's done really nice. Eyes, really well. I mean, if you already have the regular version, you already know exactly what you're getting yourself into. And here goes the regular version. As you can see, they're both done fairly well. This was honestly on my top 10 action figures of 2019. And honestly, the best Spider-Man figure. And this comic book variant, nothing different. It's just as amazing, equally amazing. As you can see, Marvel, I had no idea that even said Marvel, to be honest. Except for when I seen this one, I was like, what the hell? It says Marvel. Go figure. But just look at all that. Oh my God, looks amazing. Both these guys are done amazingly. So if you already own the other one, you already know how the articulation is, and it is amazing. He can look really far up while crawling poses. Down, side to side, crunch really far forward. Sorry, should just do that. So really far forward, just using that, then using the top and the bottom a little bit more. This far back and top and bottom that far back, which is really far back. Nice waist rotation here. Kick really far forward. Goes out to the angle a little bit. But go out at an angle, it is a lot more. What's nice is that they have the drop down method. This is how the leg sits. This does drop down to allow for more range of motion out to the side. That's what allows him to go out to the side like that. It doesn't have a whole lot of thigh rotation, but it's, you know, not like a thigh cut like a Marvel Legends, but it does allow, you know, enough range. Double jointed knee. Double jointed elbow. Butterfly joints. This far forward. And, oh, this far back. Just crazy range of motion. I think that's really good. So as far as the hands, you should already know what you're getting yourself into. Rotation. And then, so believe it or not, guys, I broke it. Snapped the peg. Uh-oh. I'm gonna have to do a repair to this guy. That's completely fine. So that's what happens if you don't go with the rotation and you go against it. So what I did is how's it going, you know, up and down. I went that way and I snapped it. No big deal, I have extra pegs, I'll fix it, I'll find a way. Anyways, you port it off, and you just swap out the hand for whatever other hand that you want to put on there. Gotta be honest, a little discouraged right now from breaking it. Only had it for less than a week, a few days. Anyways, you could change out the feet, which hopefully they don't break. For the magnet feet, as you can see, fairly easy. Just port it in. It comes with a bunch of different hands, which I'll show right now. So it comes with fists, which we've already showed and that I snapped off. He does come with some Kind of waving hands. I don't know. You could use it for a couple different effects. Whipping hands, wall crawling hands, magnetic wall crawling hands, and then also the spiderweb holding hands. As you can see, let me see. Focus. There we go. He also does come with another head. It's done really well. He also does come with the unmasked head sculpt with the extra neck accessory. So the unmasked head sculpt, there you go. And to put in the other neck accessory with the bear skin, you actually need to put this on. It's a little porting system that goes inside. So hold on, it goes like that. There we go. Boom, and it fits on there perfectly. To me, this doesn't look like, I don't know, it looks weird. It's their interpretation of Peter Parker. I honestly like the Marvel Legends head sculpt better than this. Don't really care for this a whole lot. He does come with a number of thwipping accessories. He does come with this, kind of like, right over your face. Kind of cool. Does come with a longer accessory. Goes like that. You know, web swinging accessory all across the city. He does come with two long thwipping coming out of his hand, and he does come with two smaller. So there goes a small, there goes a long ones for all you size queens out there. He does also come with the Spider-Man mask accessory, like as if you took it off. They could go hand in hand with the unmasked head sculpt. It's done really well. Yeah, I can't fault the figure for my fuck up. Hopefully you guys liked this review, found it informative how not to handle it. Please like, share, and subscribe. Make sure to follow me on Instagram at Black Hole Comics and follow my podcast at The Geek Out Show. You can listen to us anywhere that you listen to your podcast, Google Play, iTunes, Stitcher, all that good stuff. Till next time, make sure to stay geeked up and geek out. Side the winter sky.